Hey everyone, welcome you all. In the today's video, we will see how to handle PDF files. So first of all, we'll see how to read data from PDF file, and then I will show you how to write data into the PDF file. And this we can achieve by using PDFBox library, which is third-party library, which is available for Java. And by using this library, we can access a different type of classes and methods through which we can handle PDF files. So as part of this video, I will show you how to read a PDF file using PDFBox library. So first of all, we need to add a dependency in our Maven pom.xml project. So let me go to MVR repository first. And we need to search for PDFBox. You can say PDFBox. And if you want to get any official document, you can just go to this website. You can just directly search for PDFBox. And this is again from Apache Foundation, which is open source software or library. And we can go through all the documentation and different versions and different features are available. And now go back to the MVN repository. And this is Apache PDFBox. And currently the recent version, they have released 3.0.0. And previously 2.0.29, there are some changes are there between these two versions. I will show you what are those changes. First of all, let us start with the old version 2.0.29. And after that, I will also show you what are the changes I've done in the latest version. Now, let me go to 2.0. And this is a dependency we need to add in the pom.xml. Let's go to pom.xml in my Maven project, which is already created. And if you come down, I have added this dependency earlier. I'm just enabling this dependency and I'm commenting the latest version. I will show both the versions and we can also understand what is the changes. Now, this is a older version 2.0.29. After that, 3. version is got released. Now, currently I'm using old version 2.0.29. I have added dependency in the pom.xml. So once we have added, now let us start creating a Java code through which we can read data from PDF file. So I already have one PDF sample PDF file in my data folder. You can just look at here, sample.pdf. And I open this, I can see the PDF content here. There are two pages are there. And I'll try to read this content from the two pages through Java code. Okay, I'll maintain this file inside the data folder. Now go to your project, SRC Test Java. I already created a new package called PDF files. And inside this, I'm going to create a new class. I'll name it as read PDF. And also I'm taking main method and say finish. So this is a step-by-step process. Let me show you. The first step is we have to load PDF document or PDF file from the location. So for that, we have to use a normal file object. So let me create one file object, let's say file, and this is a PDF file. So PDF file equal to new file. And here I'll specify the location of my PDF file, which is there in current project location, data folder. My PDF file is sample.pdf. And now we need to import this file class from java.io itself. Now, this is the first step. We have to load PDF document. Load PDF document. So once I have loaded, now still it is not loaded. So this is the first step. Before loading, we have to just create one file object which is representing the PDF file. Now we have to load that file. So to load the file, we have a special class in PDF box that is PD document. PD document, and in this we have a method called load, and here we have to pass the file object, whichever object which is referring our PDF file that we have to pass. So this particular command will load our PDF document, and that we are going to store in a variable. I'm creating one variable called document, and the type of this variable is PD document. And this PD document dot load, we'll throw some exception, just add this. So actually this is a statement which we have to use for loading the PDF file. So first we have to create a file object, which is representing the PDF file. And then we have to load the PDF file. And once it is loaded, now we have to start reading the data from the PDF file. So for that, we need to use some additional class called PDF text stripper object we have to create. So how to create? We can say PDF stripper and PDF text stripper. So this is a special class which we have to use, PDF text stripper. For this, we need to create an object. I'm going to create one object. Is a PDF stripper equal to new PDF stripper, text stripper, PDF text stripper. Right, so this is a class which you have to import again from org.apache.pdfbox.text. So once you created this stripper, so we need to use this stripper object, PDF stripper. And in this, we have a method called getText. Inside the getText, we have to pass this document. So first we need to load the PDF document. And after that, we have to pass this document inside the PDF stripper.getText. And once you pass, what this method will do, this method will extract text from the PDF. So whatever PDF document we specified here from this document, the text will be extracted, and that we are going to store in a string variable like this. And after that, we can simply close our document, document.close. After that, we can just print the data from the document using println. So this is a simple code which you can create. So very, very simple, very easy. First, we need to open the PDF file, or we are referring the file using file object. Then we have to pass or load that PDF file using pddocument.load that we are going to store in a document. And this document we have to pass in PDF stripper.getText that will return the text from the PDF document. After closing the file, we are just printing the data from the file. So this is a simple way. We can do it. So this particular method, PDF document dot load. So this particular method is available in only 2.x. This is from 2.x. Currently, we are working on 2.x version. So this is a method which we have in 3.x. This load method is changed. I'll show you that also. Let me save the file and execute. So we already have document file here, sample.pdf. So whatever data we have, so this is sample PDF file and some content, and this is a second page, sample PDF file and some content which we have. And if I go back and see the console output, so this is the data from the first page, and this is the data from the second page. So simply we can read the data from the PDF file like this. Few steps, we have to just refer the file using file object. Then we have to load the PDF file. Once it is loaded, the PDF document we have to pass in PDF stripper.getText method, which will return the text from the PDF file. Then we'll close it and print the data. This is 2.x. Now in the 3.x, this method is got deprecated. So instead of load, they have provided another method called load PDF, which we need to access from loader class, not PD document. Okay. So I will show you how to do this. Now go to Pomlet XML. Now, instead of 2.x, I'm currently using 2.x. That means 2029. And I'll try to comment this code, comment this dependency. Now I'll try to enable the latest version, so which is 3.0.0. So when I add this latest version, as of now, 3.0.0, if I go back to your code, so this is giving an error. This method load file is undefined for the type PD document. So this is got replaced actually. So in 3.x, what we need to write it in 3.x, the same thing, PD document and document equal to PD document. Instead of PD document dot load, we have a special class is introduced called load class, loader class. And inside this, we have a method called load PDF. Loader dot load PDF, and inside this we need to pass PDF file. So this is from 3.x the latest change. So previously it was pd document.load and pdf file we have to pass, and the latest version loader.load pdf and pdf file we have to pass, and rest of the code is exactly the same. This is the new change in 3.x. Now let us try to execute one more time. Yes, now we are able to read the text from pdf file. Okay, so this is the simplest way we can handle pdf file, or we can read the content from the pdf file by using PDFBox API, and you can get the dependency from MVN repository. Or if you want to read the detailed documentation, you can just go to their official website, pdfbox.apache.org. You can see all the versions and features and examples and everything. All right. So that's all for this video. In the next video, we will see how to create our own PDF file and how can we add the data. Thanks for watching.